The machines do everything. They beat you and knead you and pummel you and shake you. You just have to be able to take it.
Here we are again. Welcome to my channel if you've never been here before. Welcome back if you have. Today I wanted to do something a little bit more creative. So I thought to make a video on the most creative things I have seen recently to help you lose weight that are still fairly healthy. I have seen a whole bunch of creative ways to lose weight, but I wasn't on board with those. They just didn't seem very healthy. So anyway, these ones are safe for you. They're interesting, but regardless, I always say have super massive fun in your life. So let's do this.
Brace yourself.
There's something called NEAT, which stands for non-exercise activity thermogenesis. So this is a fairly simple concept that does lead to weight loss. It refers to the energy expended doing natural daily activities like walking from the door of your house to the car or from your house to the bus stop or using the stairs instead of taking the elevator or parking far away from the door of whatever building you're going to. All of these things added up over time contribute greatly to the amount of weight that you can keep off of your body and as well are barely noticeable, if at all. I actually do all of those things because I genuinely prefer how it feels.
I'm weird. I'm a weirdo.
According to a research review published in Mayo Clinic Proceedings, this type of movement may help you burn upwards of 2,000 extra calories above baseline metabolic level. So this doesn't mean you can just fidget instead of doing a workout, but it does mean that if you are taking stairs where you otherwise wouldn't, or parking farther away from the building you're heading to, or just adding in little bits of extra daily movements into your life, you are going to unnoticeably burn more calories and thus unnoticeably and with way less effort help yourself lose weight or maintain a healthy weight. Slow your dinner roll with chopsticks. Who'd have thunk it, right?
Well, that's just silly.
And chopsticks can be very annoying to learn how to use. However, chopsticks are fun to use. And they're fun to learn how to use to me, I guess.
Man who catch fly with chopstick accomplish anything.
I don't even think I use them properly. However, I figured out how to use them when I was a kid. I still use them. I enjoy them. And you know what? More often than not, if you are using chopsticks, you are eating a food that is more healthy than something you can pick up with your hands, like a big fat burger or such. And as you're eating with chopsticks, you automatically have to go slower and be more mindful. And because of the slower pace of eating, your satiation response, the hormone leptin, which says leave food alone, we've had enough, is able to release itself properly in a manner that is noticed by your brain, and you automatically feel full sooner than you otherwise would. You just can't eat that quickly with chopsticks as you can with a fork or a spoon. The American Journal of Clinical Nutrition presented a review and analysis of 22 different studies that proved that a slower intake of food was associated with lower caloric intake. If chopsticks are not your jam and you're like, I'm way too stressed out trying to eat, forget about it. Just eat slower. Same thing accomplished. You can banish unnecessary munchies with chewing gum. Please note, I have not seen this anywhere yet, but there is very important information that chewing gum for longer than a 10-minute time period can have a negative effect on your digestive processes. So if you do want to banish munchies with chewing gum, please pick a healthy one like this one, Pure. It is aspartame free. Aspartame will backfire as it tricks your brain into thinking you need more food when you don't.
What are you eating?
I don't even know. I just know I'm hungry.
All the time.
So use a clean chewing gum, chew that up for about 10 minutes, and you'll be able to stave off hunger a little bit longer. So you'll make it from work to home without stopping at a drive-thru or without the vending machine pit stop on the way out the door. A new crossover study that was published in Physiology and Behavior, conducted in healthy weight and obese women, found that chewing gum after lunch for about 15 minutes per hour over a 3-hour period will actually boost satiety as well as help reduce high carbohydrate snacking later on in the afternoon. Side note, keep in mind I will post below a video that helps to explain what to do if you find yourself craving higher carbo things in the afternoon. That means you are lacking somewhere earlier in the day, aka possibly breakfast, higher fat and protein content that keeps those cravings at bay. Did you know you can fool yourself with pistachios? Not only is it a heck ton of work to open each pistachio, I mean,
ain't nobody got time for that,
right? But the shells left over give your brain a visual cue of how much you've actually had, and this can help up that satiety response because you are visually seeing how much you've eaten. And this will curb intake, leading to reduced caloric consumption. And did you know that pistachios are actually one of the lower calorie nuts, clocking in at 160 calories per serving? That's not too bad. And nuts are good for you. That's about 49 of those little guys. So go ahead and snack on them. Downsize your dinner plate. I have spoken in another video previously as well that eating the same amount of food on a smaller plate does trick your brain into believing that you have eaten more. So you're not cutting your calories here. You are not necessarily eating too little. You're eating enough, but it's on a smaller plate. So you're actually fooling your brain into realizing that you have eaten far more than you have. Not only that, if you are eating a dish such as spaghetti and meatballs or something that's high in caloric value and, you know, not necessarily the healthiest dish, you will serve yourself less in a good way by serving yourself onto a smaller dish. Did you know that back in the day, the average American dinner plate was 9.6 inches in diameter, and now they are 11.8 inches on average? That is super unfair ridiculousness.
Oh man, you are so dramatic.
Get back to the old school. Look at these old school portion sizes. I mean, come on. Let's get back to the 50s when it comes to how we're eating.
Okay, get over it.
This does result in about 23% fewer calories being consumed, and oftentimes unnecessary ones at that. But if you are eating a meal with a lot of veggies that you're ingesting in that meal, using a larger plate will actually entice you and help you eat more of those vegetables. So a spaghetti and meatball-ish kind of dish, use a smaller plate. Something like stir fry, veggies, chicken, rice, eat it on a larger plate. Win-win everywhere. Another interesting study published in the Journal of Consumer Research found that people tend to serve themselves less when there is a greater contrast between the plate and the food that is being eaten off of it. So if you are eating, you know, white rice, let's say, off of a blue or green plate, you are going to serve yourself less, whereas yellow, orange, and red plates entice you to eat more. Not only that, the color blue has actually been shown to shut off that appetite a little bit. So if you're eating off of a blue tablecloth, a blue placemat, blue plates, or in a blue room, you're naturally going to be eating less food. It's just not as appetizing to your brain. Going back to that plate of veggies idea, if you are eating vegetables with your meal, or if you're not, add in half of your plate full of veggies. Make sure it is half full of vegetables. You're gonna be eating a lot less of the bad stuff, a lot more of those beneficial veggies, which also gives you more of those beneficial vitamins and minerals and nutrients that we need. This is an evidence-based strategy for weight loss. The American Diabetes Association actually encourages this tactic for helping to maintain blood glucose levels to help lower that high blood sugar. Many companies even sell pre-portioned out plates if you need that extra bit of help there. Okay, restaurants aren't only trying to jazz up your romance level by turning those lights down and the music up, which you do notice in a lot of restaurants. Turns out, low lighting lowers eating inhibitions. And as for music, if you do put on soft music very low in the background, as in classical music, it will help to stimulate the digestion process to work more efficiently for you. And it encourages more leisurely chewing, which slows your eating down, thus lowering your caloric intake again. It just works against those super stressed out, mindless, hurry up eating patterns that we have developed in this Western civilization of ours. Okay, and this one I thought was super silly to do, but really interesting to know, was that Alan R. Hirsch, he is the MD Neurological Director of the Smell and Taste Treatment and Research Foundation of Chicago, took 3,000 people and found that the more frequently these 3,000 volunteers sniffed foods like peppermint or bananas or apples, the less hungry they naturally were and the more weight they lost. One theory is that sniffing these foods is actually tricking your brain into believing that it's eaten those foods. I personally have no sense of smell, so I can't even tell you if it's gonna work on me, but I am interested to try that out. What have you got to lose? And the last interesting way of losing weight that I have heard of recently would be to place yourself strategically in front of a mirror or, you know, where your reflection is visible, not directly in front of a mirror, but if you're in a restaurant that's got mirrors, try to seat yourself where you can sort of see your reflection, or at someone's home, if they have one of those big mirrors on the wall of their dining room, seat yourself in an area where you can see your own reflection, and by golly, you end up eating less food. This has been shown to slash the amount of food someone eats by a third. Being able to see yourself tends to reflect back to you some of your own inner standards and goals that you have for yourself and your weight loss or your health goals. So, who knows? What if you sit there and you sniff some peppermint or a banana or an apple while you listen to some low classical music in the background, facing a mirror, eating with your chopsticks, and the lights are up? Who knows, right? Anyway, I thought I'd give you something to think about, something to try out. Who knows? So please do hit that subscribe button down below. Please do share this channel, because there are videos all over this channel that will help heal more than 90% of any health, wellness, and body image challenge. Please hit that little bell notification icon down below if you would like a notification of when I do post future videos. If you thought this video was helpful, informative, entertaining at all, please give it a thumbs up for me down there with that little thumbs up icon, as that really does help support my channel and it helps me know to continue creating content like this in the future. If you have any questions, concerns, comments, or content ideas for me for future videos, please comment those down below or send me a message. I do Q&A videos as well, so keep your eye out for that. And until next time, have super amounts of fun in your life and have super amounts of fun experimenting on your own with these little tricks or with tricks you might think of yourself. If you think of any, let me know. I'd be interested. I have put my info in the description box down below if you want to know a little bit more about me. And I will see you next time. Till then. Bye.